Welcome to Hardware Development Series. In this video, we will place all the components transferred from the schematic to the PCB and we will add connections to the PCB using various layout functions in the Altium designer. Altium is widely used by all multinational companies in the field of electronics like Texas Instruments, ST Microelectronics, Siemens, Seagate, Philips, and Microsoft, HP, Lenovo, and some other companies like Audi, Boeing, Broadcom, and even NASA is also using Altium products for their design. We will also generate PCB fabrication files and then we will get this PCB manufactured by PCBWay.com. We all know that PCBWay.com is an online PCB ordering platform where we can get PCBs delivered at our home with simple steps. Currently, PCBWay has started PCBWay big sale due to Christmas. There are a lot of exciting offers. Get your PCBs ready at PCBWay.com. The link is in the description below. So let's dive into the episode.
Now we are ready to transfer the design to the PCB. To do that, first go to the design pull-down menu and select Update PCB Recharge Hub. This enables a window to pop up which contains every detail of action we have performed, the affected object, the affected document and all. If the project was not compiled, the tool will compile it and create a unified data model of the design. The Unified Data Model or UDM provides the linking between the schematic and PCB. First of all, we need to validate changes and then we can execute the changes. To do that, first click on the Validate Changes button. This will validate all changes we have performed and gives a status indication. A green tick means passed and a red tick means failed. Hopefully, we have passed all the validation changes. Now click on the Execute Changes. This will execute all the changes and update all passed changes to the PCB document. This will also show status indication whether it is executed or not. Hopefully, we got all our changes are executed and components are updated to the PCB file. Then just close this window. At this stage, we have a two-layer PCB with components showing their connectivity. As you can see, the parts are placed off the PCB and are in a group called Room. This room is auto-generated based on the schematics. First of all, I prefer to set the origin of the board to the lower left corner. To do this, open Edit pull-down menu and select Origin and then select Set. Now with the mouse, we can place the 0,0 coordinates for the port by selecting the bottom left corner of the PCB and then left mouse click as shown here. We will change the board size from the default dimensions. We will be changing the board size to 4.725 by 6.3 inches. To edit the board shape, we need to enter into the board planning mode by hitting the number 1 key. With the PCB now green indicating, we are in the edit mode. We can directly work on the PCB using the design pull-down menu. Select the Edit Board Shape option to allow us to pick on the vertices of the board and move them. We could adjust the height and length of the board using X and Y coordinates as a guide. The coordinates reflect the current mass position. We will set the board to desired 4.725 by 6.3 inches size and then deselect. To switch back to the 2D mode, hit the number 2 key. Now the board size is edited. The next thing is to transfer all the components from the room to PCB. While placing components on the PCB, we need to make sure that controlling components should be easily accessible and the wiring between the components should be minimized as little as possible. First of all, I'm gonna place these 4 battery holders on the upper side. Then the TP4056 modules on the lower side. Then input mail header and input status LED at the below of TP4056 module. And battery connectors are going to place between TP4056 module and battery holder. Finally, mail headers which are going to use as a switches are placed on top of the PCB. Now all components are placed on the PCB. We will continue moving parts and utilizing connection lines to fine-tune the placement of the PCB. I will use few more lines to rearrange the components to maintain the symmetry between components. This will allow us to make the PCB look more beautiful. Here is the final placement of the design. While this design does not require placing components on the bottom side, all the components are placed on the top layer only. Let's move to the next step, PCB routing. Looking at the PCB, we see there are empty and through-hole devices. This provides us with the top and bottom layer as routing choices. Now let's make a start on layout by selecting the top layer and doing some manual routing. We will use interactive routing for this. This can be selected from the active menu on the top. At this point, we can simply click on the pin we wish to start routing, then move away and finish the routing by making the connection with the other pin. Since we are on the top layer, the track will be in red color. We can open the properties panel by double clicking on the routed track. You can see the properties of the track here. As you can see here, the track width is 10 mils, which is default for signal tracks. But in our project, we are using it for charging batteries. So it is better to have a more track width to deliver more current. I have decided to have a 1 millimeter track width. If we convert 1 mm to millis, it is around 40 mils. So let's enter the same thing here. The 40 mils track will be something like this. If I wanted to have a 40 mils track width, I should edit every track after routing, which is difficult task. We can configure the default width from the properties panel itself. Here you can see that all the width preferences are set to 10 mils. First, we need to change that. To do that, go to the Design pull-down menu and select Rules. This will enable a PCB Rules Editor window to pop up. There are a bunch of categories of rules. Select Routing category and then select Width option. Here we can edit minimum width, preferred width, and maximum width of the track. I want to keep maximum width of 100 mils and preferred width is 40 mils and minimum width of 10 mils. Then click on Apply. Then click on OK. Now go back to the properties and select the preferred width 40 mils. That's it. From now onwards, every track we will route will have 40 mils width. Let's start routing by simply clicking on the pin we wish to start routing. Then move away and finish the routing by making the connection with other pin. Then repeat the same thing with other input pins of TP4056 module. Here, I am not allowed to route the connection between these two pins because there is a ground line. So I will simply connect these two pins to the bottom layer. Since we are on the bottom layer, the track will be in blue color. Then we will continue to route the rest of the 5 volts net tracks between battery and TP4056 module and battery connector. Now all positive net tracks are routed. The ground net tracks are left unconnected. But we are not going to connect them with the general routing. We will use another technique. To provide these connections, we will use polygon planes. Go to the active menu and select Place Polygon Plane. Before we place the polygon, hit the tab key. So we can pass the polygon power mode and edit the properties of polygon. In the properties window, change the net from no net to ground from the drop down list and hit enter. Now we can place the vertices of the polygon at four corners of the PCB as shown here. Now we have placed a polygon on the bottom layer. Let's hide this layer and continue to place the polygon on the top layer. Repeat the same thing with top layer too. That's it. The polygon layer is also powered on the top layer. As you can see, any through-hole component that has a ground assigned to it is automatically connected to the polygon. The SMT pins that also need connection to the ground are automatically connected to the polygon. So, the routing part is completed successfully. Now, let's enter into the branding part. I want to place my website URL on the top silk layer. We will use the string option for this. Also place the website URL and logo of my YouTube channel to the bottom silk layer. Thus, the branding part is also completed. The final PCB in 2D mode will look like this. Altium provides a 3D mode feature to see the PCB layout in 3D view as it can give us a real-life perspective of placement and layout. To enable 3D mode, just hit the number 3 key. This is how our PCB look in 3D view. To rotate the view in 3D, hold the shift key to get the trackball to appear and then use the right mouse button to rotate the 3D view. We can play with this feature. This gives us some sort of satisfaction with the work that we have done till now. I enjoy playing with this feature. To reset the 3D view, hit the number 2 key. That's it. The PCB designing process is completed. Let's save all the files first. The only thing left is to generate the fabrication files. But before going to that process, we need to perform the DRC, which is also stands for Design Rule Checker. This will validate our design and checks whether our PCB obeying all the design rules or not, and also check for any other violations. This will help us to minimize the future problems and solve them at the design stage only. So let's do that first. To do that, go to the Tools pull-down menu and select the Design Rule Check option. This will enable the Design Rule Checker window to pop up. Click on the Run Design Rule Check option from the bottom right corner of the window. This will generate a design rule verification report. Here, it is showing total of 20 violations, which are 12 violations of hole size constraints and 8 violations of silk to solder mask clearance. Let's see what are these violations. Hole size constraints. Here it is showing the hole size is 135 mils, but the rule is stating that it should be less than 100 mils. But this is okay, because it is from the battery footprint itself, so we can waive it. Then silk to solder mask clearance is also from the footprint itself, so we can waive it and move forward. Close the report and save the project files. At this point, we are now ready to generate the needed files for PCB manufacturing, which includes Gerber and NC drill files for PCB fabrication and pick and place files for PCB assembly. To generate the needed Gerber files, use the File pull-down menu and select Fabrication Outputs and then select Gerber Files. This opens up Gerber Setup window. Here we can review and change the setting to suit our fabrication requirements. Under the General tab, we will select 2:3 for format as we do not require very high precision. Clicking on the Layers tab, we need to select which layers to plot for the Gerber files. There are no layers selected by default. I often select Usual On from the Plot Layers pull-down menu at the bottom left corner of the window. This allows the tool to plot all the user layers in the PCB. Under the Drill Drawing tab, I usually select Plot All User Drill Pair for both sections. Click OK to start the generation process. After the Gerber generation done, the Camtastic viewer opens with various layers plotted. We can see the files generated under the Generated folder in the project panel. We got our Gerber files, so just close this file and do not save it. Let's generate the NC drill files using the File pull-down menu, then Fabrication file, and then selecting NC drill files. This opens up the NC drill setup window. We will keep the defaults but change the format 2:3 and click OK. Click OK again. After NC drill file generated, the Camtastic NC drill drawing viewer opens. We can see the drills on this view. We can see the files generated under the generated folder in the project panel. I normally close and do not save this view. Now we have the Gerber files and NC drill files generated. Now we can generate pick and place files using File pull-down menu and Assembly Output and selecting Generate pick and place files. This opens up the pick and place setup window where we can configure the pick and place file for our particular vendor and output format whether it is CSV or text depending on what is needed. Clicking OK generate the files. We can see the just generated pick and place file under the generated folder in the project panel. As you can see here, the generated files are located under the project files / project outputs for recharge hub directory. We need to send these files to pcbware.com to get our PCBs manufactured. So let's generate a zip file of these files to transfer easily. The zip file is created successfully. Finally, the PCB designing part and generation of fabrication files process is completed. We will order PCBs on pcbware.com using these files in the next episode. Coming to the summary of the episode, first of all, we have created this schematic document and added this battery holder with the help of Altium library loader. Then we have created our own schematic and PCB library for TP4056 module and added to the schematic. Then added few more components and connected all the components, then finalized the schematic. Then transferred all these files to the PCB file and fine-tuned the PCB placement and completed the PCB routing part. Then added few branding strings and logos and then generated PCB fabrication files. Thus completed the final PCB designing part. So that's it for this tutorial. See you in the next episode. Bye-bye.